Namaskar, myself Vijayalakshmi Pradhan. I welcome you all to today's topic. Today we will discuss about the needs of measurement and SI units of fundamental quantities. In science, particularly in physics, we try to make measurements as precisely as possible. Every measurement must be expressed in some units. For example, if you measure the length of your room, it is expressed in suitable units. You say it is 10 meter or 15 meter. So the meter is the unit here. Similarly, if you measure the interval between two events, it is expressed in some other units. The unit of a physical quantity is derived by expressing it in base units fixed by international agreement. The idea of base units leads us to concept of dimensions, which, as you shall see, has important applications in physics. So, what is the need of measurement? For complete and proper study of any phenomenon, measurements of quantities involved is essential. For example, to study the motion of a particle, measurement of its displacement, velocity, and acceleration at any instant has to be made accurately. For this, measurement of time and distance has to be done. Similarly, measurement of volume, pressure, and temperature is necessary to study the state of a gas fully. Thus, we find that measurement of quantities such as distance, time, temperature, mass, force, etc. has to be made to study every natural phenomena. This explains the need for measurement. Here you can see that a car is moving on the road. If you want to express its velocity, then you have to measure how much distance it has covered in how much time. So you need measurement for that. So now, how will we express any measurement? So now we will discuss unit of measurement. The laws of physics are expressed in terms of physical quantities such as distance, speed, time, force, volume, electric current, etc. For measurement, each physical quantity is assigned a unit. For example, time could be measured in minutes, hours, or days. But for communication among people of different countries, this unit must be compared with a standard unit acceptable to all. For example, if we say that the distance between Mumbai and Kolkata is nearly 2000 kilometers, then the basic unit for comparison is a kilometer. It is essential that all agree on the standard units so that when we say 100 kilometers or 10 kilogram or 10 hours, others understand what we mean by them. In science, international agreement on the basic units is absolutely essential. Otherwise, scientists in one part of the world would not understand the results of an investigation conducted in another part. For example, if we say 10 ratti sodium chloride, then it will not be understood by everybody as ratti is not a standard unit. In science, the results of an investigation are considered established only if they can be reproduced by investigations conducted elsewhere under identical conditions. Practices of systemic measurement are very old in India. You can see from the table the different units of measurement used in different period of time in India. Now we will discuss about SI units. The 14th General Conference on Weights and Measures held in 1971 adopted 7 base or fundamental units, which units form the SI system. SI means System International de Units, for the International System of Units. The SI system of units has 7 fundamental or base units. For mass, it is kg, for time, second, for length, meter, for current, it is ampere, which is denoted as A, capital A. For amount of substance, the unit is mole for luminous intensity, it is CD or candela. For temperature, it is Kelvin denoted by capital K. SI system is a metric system. Smaller and larger units of the base units, which are submultiples and multiples of 10, are given special names. You can see the list from the table on your screen. Here there are many submultiple and multiples of units and their prefixes. For example, auto is taken as 10 to the power minus 18, femto 10 to the power minus 15, pico 10 to the power minus 12. These are the smaller units. And for larger units, you can see they are hexa, that is 10 to the power 18, peta 10 to the power 15, tera 10 to the power 12, giga is 10 to the power 9, etc. So you can use this multiples and submultiples and their prefixes to denote smaller and larger units. Now we will discuss standards of mass, length and time. The SI unit of mass is kilogram. It is the mass of a particular cylinder made of platinum iridium alloy, which is an usually alloy. For length, the SI unit of length is meter. 1 meter is defined as the distance traveled by light in vacuum in a time interval of 1/299792458 second. The velocity of light in vacuum is generally taken as 3×10⁸ meter per second. It is approximate. But 1 meter is defined as the distance traveled by light in vacuum in a time interval of 1 divided by this much, that is 299792458 second. That is taken as the standard unit of length, that is 1 meter. 1 second is defined as the time required for a cesium-133, that is 133 cesium atom, to undergo 91926317770 vibrations between 2 hyperfine level of its ground state. Now we will discuss about derived units. We have already studied about the SI units of base quantities, but for the SI units of other physical quantities, we have to derive the units by using the base units. Units which we get by combining the basic units are called derived units. For example, combination of the units of length and time gives us the derived unit of speed or velocity. The unit of velocity is meter per second. Here you can see meter is the unit of length and second is the unit of time. As the formula for speed or velocity is displacement by time or distance by time. Displacement or distance is length. So we have used the unit of that, that is meter, and for time we have used the unit second. So here this unit is a derived unit. You can see on the screen examples of many other derived units. For force, the unit is Newton. Its symbol is capital N, and it is written as, if you derive the unit from base fundamental units, it is kg meter per second square. Here you can see the three units used, kg, meter and second, are base units. For pressure similarly, its SI unit is Newton per meter square. And for Newton, you can again use kg meter per second square. Energy unit is Joule, it is Newton into meter. Newton can be expressed in terms of kg meter per second square. For power, unit is watt and it is expressed as joule per second. Today we have discussed about the need of measurement, expressing the measurement in terms of units. Also we have discussed about SI units and derived units. I hope you have understood what we have discussed today. Thank you.